stressless chair where the seat cushion has to be replaced. So I'm going to show you how to do that. What you start off to do is take the chair, put it on its side, and you can see that the cushion is messed up on the bottom of that. So we're going to have to get that out and put a new one in. But we got to pop these off, and we've got to unzip that and disattach that thing from the back. So there's one, two spots, and then three, four on the other side. So let's do that. Let me show you the tools you're going to need. First things first, you got to pop this part off here, which I find just using a little razor blade, and that will expose, that's just the stressless nameplate cover on each side, and that will expose where this goes in, okay? And then you just got to break that loose, and that will come off. Now I want you to pay attention to how that goes on there, because it's important it goes back on the same way. The open part at the bottom, fat part at the top. Take a picture of that for you. And so do the same thing on the other side. Just pull that off. And once again, pay attention that the fat part, the big part is at the top, and the open part is at the bottom, and you just gotta crack this. Yeah, it takes a little bit of doing. You gotta crack that loose. Crack it loose, and what you're gonna do is go ahead and take that completely off. And that comes off like that, so it's gonna go right back into that hole whenever we get that all done. You wanna make sure, watch out that there's a little washer that sits in there, and you don't want to lose that. Okay, so that's going to be, and also take note that the ridge, where that ridge is the back, and on the front is kind of flat. So the ridge is the back, goes into this ridge here. So these ridges are ridges, and this is going to be, oops, see, I dropped the washer, I'll pick that up, and that's going to go in. So let's take the other one off now too, on the other side. And that's just a deal where you and that part comes right off. Once again, note the ridge end is in the back and the flat part is in the front. Kind of the tilty thing is in the front, and it's going to go back on with the fat part on the top. See, I lost the washer again, so don't lose that washer. Okay, make sure you pay attention to how it comes off so you can put it right back on the same way. So now we've got the sides off of the slide part, and as you can see, with the sides off, this part slides up and down, and I think that makes it a little bit easier to disattach the back, so we'll do that now. To do that, and that will expose where, try not to rip up your foam, that will expose a bolt there and a bolt on the other side. Maybe dark, but believe me, it's there. And these keep them kind of a bear to break loose. I think they may have some Loctite on that, which is some liquid you can buy to dump in there, and you may want to put that back in when you put this back on. And that takes off this part. Let's take a picture of that for you. And once that's off, then you got this little screw, and we got to remember how that goes back on there. And that's going to be pretty easy. They fit back on pretty easy, so it's got to slide in. And don't lose that, of course. And then you do the same on the other side. Ugh. Man, those are hard to break loose. Turn off the camera and do it, because you got to really get it to break it loose. But once you get it loose, it's okay. Then you just do just like that, and pull the screw out. It looks like that. And at that point, this whole part should just come right off, just like like that. So we've got the seat cushion off
there.
Okay, so we got the seat cushion off, got these two clamps on each side of it. You can see where they're gonna go back in there. I used some leather conditioner on this while I was waiting for the parts to come in. Okay, so then we've simply got to take this leather off of this, and it can be kind of a bear. You got to be careful not to rip stuff up when you do it, and it takes two hands, so I'm going to do that off camera. So there's one side. Actually wasn't as hard. Did another one, was kind of harder. Actually this one's feeling like it's going to be a bear too. Okay, you got to pull, you got to stretch that leather up without ripping it and get that off. Okay, so got both sides off. And when you're peeling this back, make sure you're gentle with it. There's the inside. You want to keep this kind of soft stuff attached to the leather and not to disattach it to the leather. So that ought to all come out. And you got to pull it over the side parts there. And over the side parts here. You got to put these things back on, so don't forget. At which point, we now have the leather part off. There's the old, and we'll just toss that away. New cushion. Now we got to fight a little bit to get the leather part back on top of that. Not exactly easy, but you just got to be careful not to rip things up. Take your time, stretch it, and go easy. So let's do that. Okay, so we're getting it on there. Stretching it over. And your first goal on getting these is to get both of these side holes on there and aim for that, and then kind of wiggle it into place so there's not a lot of stress like that. So let's do that. And we're getting there. And same on this side. Okay, then what you got to do is bring this over the top and get this hole into this thing. And don't rip it, go easy. And we got one on there. Like I say, that's just leather conditioner. It'll rub out. It's not really dirt. Now we got to do this other one. Okay. Okay. And we got that one on. That one on. Then you just zip the back up. And then it's time to put the chair back together. Pretty simple. And I'm going to do the side parts first, and then I'll do the back. So let's put the chair on the side and do that. And get your plastic parts back onto the sleeve around the leather there nicely. Then it's just a matter of putting this back on there. Okay, maybe you can see that rising up to where it's tight. Good, good. Good, good. On there, good, nicely. Now do the other side. Okay, and it's the same thing here. Where can you see this bottom part? Tighten up as we go. And that should be in there tight. Tight, tight, good, good. Okay. Okay, and then it's just a matter, that's why I put the side parts on first. Just a matter of getting those holes lined up on each other. Can you see the holes? And once you got the holes lined up, then you just screw them back in. I guess it's got to be aligned a little bit better than that. Can't do it with, I need four hands for this. Hold on. Once it's lined up properly, and you want those tight, I may come back and put some Loctite, go buy some Loctite stuff and put on there. Ugh. Okay, yeah. Okay, so that one's on, nice and tight. Okay, okay, it's another instance where you just gotta line those holes up, get that stuck in there right. Get our hex driver. Oh goody, this one is lined up nicely to start with. Okay, and that's good. So let's see, this seat is, chair is only put together by three pivot points. One puts the back on, which is attached to that, which is attached to the side. And you just gotta have the right tools put together. Then you zip that up. Good measure. Make sure your armrests are nice and tight. Good, good. Hang on. And this chair is back in action. Let me sit in it to make sure it's all good. And then you put your caps back on the side, and that chair is complete. Good to go. And that's how you do it.